Barakata Yahweh, Barakata Yahweh Shai, Barakata Yahweh, Barakata Yahweh Shai, Barakata Yahweh, Barakata Yahweh Shai.
I'm just gonna go. I don't care what you say, fam. Like for real. But the weakest thing is for somebody to speak on anybody that's going through a traumatic event in their life, and you don't know the truth. You was not there. I was not there in the room.
And shalom, brothers and sisters. This is Gone to the Dark, and this is not scoffing. It's just putting the truth out there to Israel so you could actually understand what's going on. As you just heard the brother Mahavakar say, he wasn't there, we wasn't there. But I mean, this is public information. So I'm going to go ahead and put out there what I've actually learned through, you know, the assistance and research of my good brother Eliezer. And so if you are actually in Israel and, you know, you're on YouTube, you probably seen some YouTube videos that Mahavakar has actually put out in regards to this woman that you see on the screen that's referred to as Miss Judah. So, you know, research has actually shown me that he was once considering her as one of his wives. He said, "This is my Isha." Well, he doesn't seem to be making any of those claims in these more recent videos since she's actually, you know, been recently on the murder trial, and they came back with a verdict of guilty of murder on three different counts. Now, Mahavakar is a legend that no one knows, so we're going to delve into this and see what actually happened according to the evidence, because a brother's actually been asking for a deluge of money, about, you know, $50,000. And, you know, you haven't been disclosing any information, brother. So it's not just I that's been stating this. I conversed with another brother, saying the brother's asking for money, but he's not going into any kind of detail. He's just asking for money, and he wants you to provide money on the strength for being an Israelite. So today what we're going to do is we're going to delve into this case. But first, let's, you know, just show that Mahavakar did once classify her as his wife. Now, mind you, he took her as a rib after this was actually committed, which was actually murder. When we go through these articles, according to the verdict, it was murder, which is why she's now currently facing 30 years or more. What some of the articles left out is that the man was actually shot in the back and left for dead. And though he was actually shot in the building, they literally found him dead on the lawn. So what that suggests is that he probably was actually trying to get help, and, you know, more than likely bled out. But we're going to look into this. But first, let's see why Mahavakar has been actually asking for money for her without explanation, saying that her life is on the line. Now, I would turn your attention, everyone's attention, also to the man that lost his life. Nothing was actually stated about this man, but there was allegations asserted by Mahavakar, I surmise, that came from Miss Judah, a.k.a. Sharice Douglas, that alleged that this man was abusive. But there was no indications of that in this man's history, nor was there any markings on her body. And the fact that he was shot in the back, well, you decide. But we're going to go into this, then I'm going to open it up for calls. But first, I want you to look at some of these excerpts that I have here, and a couple of the videos. And then we're going to cover these clippings, and we're going to delve into this thing and put it out there just so Israel can know. Because one of the things that I definitely didn't like is, in turn, what she done is she started using the Israelite way of life as a method of why she should be justified in doing what she did. She made it seem as though being an Israelite, she's always submissive. She can't have a bank account or anything of that, not, you know, matter. Now, in fact, her attorney was alleging this. And since he was alleging that, he had to have actually gotten this information from somewhere. And so Mahalakai has actually been leaving everyone in the dark. So I've done some investigative work. And so I'm going to bring forth to all of Israel the information that I have, because many of you have actually been sympathetic for Miss Judah, a.k.a. Carice Douglas. But what about the other party? What about the victim? What about the man who was actually shot in the back? So we're going to look at this. Now, allegedly, this woman, Carice Douglas, a.k.a. Miss Judah, allegedly said that she was choked by this guy. She's been in an abusive relationships. But there's no such police reports indicating any of this. So they're just allegations according to the law, right? See, the law, you deal with the facts and the law, not emotions, not allegations, but the facts and the law. And none of the facts shows any of this. And, you know, there's been a lot of talk about she's being railroaded, but what are the facts and what are the law that actually proved this? So she's been, you know, found guilty of malice murder, felony murder, and aggravated assault in the fatal shooting of 38-year-old John Anthony Johnson, her husband of 10 days, only 10 days, and she faces 30 years in prison or more. So we're going to look at some of the news clips, analyze these, then we're going to look at some of the findings on these reports, and we're going to get to the bottom of this, because let's face it, guys, Mahalakai hasn't been forthwith with this information. You're asking for large amounts of money, but you're not really giving, you're not divulging what you know, right? And, you know, Zabak, he made a video in response, but, you know, he was, Zabak was really empathetic because he didn't put your name out there. He didn't say Mahalakai. He just said a brother formerly of HOI, but I was able to put that together. So, you know, the good brother Zabak was being generous, you know, and, you know, really not saying the name, but nevertheless, we're going to have a look at this, and we're going to let you decide, and I'll open it up if you guys want to come on and, you know, answer some, you know, questions, ask questions, or make statements, or what have you, but just show decorum. This is not a debate session or argument session, but it's just so Israel could be in the know. Because let's face it, most Israel are in the dark. You don't know what's going on, other than the brothers asking for money and say she's fighting for her life. But we're gonna delve into it.
You don't know what's going on in somebody's mind. This is the first time ever in the legal system.
It's fair enough, brother, but it's also the victim's first time in the legal system. Well, there's been no indication of this brother having any kind of prior history of reported domestic violence or domestic abuse. So as far as the system is concerned, these are mere allegations. What are the facts and what is the law? Emotions go out the window.
So that means this woman lived a life. She's from Memphis, Tennessee. She was outside in the world. She was living a life down the whole nine. But this is her first situation. A sister that came from being a masculine woman, dealing with women, right? Being a man in the situation. And then repent and try to come into the truth of the Most High and transform and become feminine and be a woman and be a wife. And then an experience as this happened with her in her relationship with this dude. I don't know how long. I know they was married legally for 10 days. I don't know how long they was together. But you don't know. But there's brothers that's in the Maccabees in Memphis. They know way more information concerning their union.
But we do know some facts. Is it not a fact, Mahala Kar, that she sent the text message stating, sis, I'm about to kill dude? See, that's the fact. That's the fact. That's evidence against her. And her attorney, from my perspective, my opinion, seems almost, her defense attorney seemed almost incompetent. And that's my opinion. I'm entitled to my opinion. I mean, with some of the things that he came forth with, what I learned from my findings is that shortly after she texted us, within an hour, the guy was shot in the back. She leaves and head back to Memphis and sells the gun en route. Sells the gun en route. See, if you get out of your emotions and you look at this clearly, all of this apparently is considered to be premeditated, which makes it murder. You see? This is why she wasn't charged with manslaughter. You got to understand how the law works. And again, this is not legal advice. I did not offer legal advice. If you need legal advice, seek a self-competent counsel and please be advised. Everything I'm giving is strictly for educational, entertainment, and informational purposes only. One of the things that made me disgruntled is that in court, she covered as, you know, a submissive rib. But we see this image. And then the trajectory of, you know, what they refer to as a religion is why she was so submissive and couldn't even have a bank account to make, you know, the Israelite way of life just seems like horrific. I didn't appreciate that.
Whitaker, we begin tonight following the 2021 murder trial of a woman charged in the fatal shooting of her husband of 10 days. That trial now in its fourth day.
WRBL's Olivia Yepes was the only reporter in the courtroom, and she has the latest on the case.
Thursday, jurors heard testimony from the medical examiner and 34-year-old Charisse Douglas herself. Douglas is on trial for the 2021 murder of her husband of 10 days, 38-year-old John Anthony Johnson. The medical examiner testified wounds on the body of Douglas's husband indicate he was shot at an intermediate range.
What I didn't appreciate about this particular testimony is that it wasn't stated here, and it was actually only stated in one article that he was actually shot in the back.
In this case, there are most references will tell you an intermediate or medium range will be between about 3 inches to 3 feet, but we can narrow in on that based on the density of the amount of gunpowder. And so the more dense the gunpowder is, the closer it is, and then it will spread from further away. This only spreads about 2 inches away from the wound, but based on that, it seems to be less than a foot.
If I heard correctly, he said it seemed to be less than 1 foot.
According to Douglas's testimony, she shot Johnson fearing for her life when the two got into an altercation after Douglas texted him asking for money to leave their shared apartment at Gentian Village.
So he doesn't give her the money to leave. Things spiral out of control and he ends up dead. And one report said he was shot in the back.
Douglas said her text to her sister, "I'm about to kill dude," wasn't literal. Under cross-examination, she verified there were only minutes between the text and the shooting.
So there was only minutes between the time that she texts, "Sis, I'm about to kill dude," and she actually did it. That's premeditated murder, you guys. How is that not murder? According to the law. Not according to your emotions. According to the law, that's premeditated. You said you was going to do it. You did it within a minute.
The defendant also testified she left the apartment and sold the gun for $350 to a friend of a friend in Alabama within an hour of the incident while under cross-examination.
She shot this man, left. And I'm assuming that she had to take the money, right? Because remember, she asked for money to leave. She left, and she sold the gun in or out within an hour. You have to contact someone to plan to sell the gun. Think about it, guys.
WRBL News 3, I'm Phil Scoggins. We now have a verdict in the murder trial of a woman who fatally shot her husband of 10 days back in 2021. WRBL's Olivia Yepes was the only reporter in the courtroom. She joins us now with more details. Olivia?
Phil, today the jury heard closing arguments from both the state and the defense. They spent less than an hour deliberating before making a final decision. Guilty on all charges.
So we see guilty on all charges. Mahara Kasi sits, is fighting for her life. It's unfortunate that the brother can no longer fight for his. He's into a spiritual realm now. We have to do what's correct in these particular situations and not feel sympathetic for people just because they have a specific gender. You literally have to call a murderer a murder. See, in the laws of the Most High is righteous judgment. Judge righteously. Get out of your emotions. All of you that may be in your emotions and see this for what it actually is. Deal with the facts and the law. Even in the eyes of the Most High and the laws of the Most High, this is a guilty verdict. Do you understand?
Before making a final decision. Guilty on all charges. On the evening of May 1st, 2021, Sharice Douglas fatally shot her husband of 10 days, John Anthony Johnson, at their shared Gentian Village apartment. In testimony, Douglas confirmed she left the scene in the minutes following the shooting and drove to her home in Memphis, Tennessee, selling the gun on the way. Douglas testified she shot Johnson to protect herself. Her lawyer, defense attorney Anthony Johnson, called into question testimony made by the victim's friend and faith counselor, which implied Douglas had a split personality.
Mahara Khan's asking for a lot of money for attorneys, expensive attorneys. The man that you see on the screen right now is Chief Justice Errol Warren. I do a lot of research on the law, though I'm not a lawyer. Chief Justice Errol Warren says 90% of all lawyers are incompetent. And the display that this lady, Miss Judah's attorney, gave in court, I would concur with Chief Justice Earl Warren. Now, did you guys know that 9 in every 10 federal defendants and 3 in every 4 state defendants in the largest countries in the world is found guilty, regardless of the type of attorney? You may want to muse over that.
You're going to say, count one, Sharice Douglas. Certainly not guilty. Count two, Sharice Douglas, felony murder. Certainly not guilty. Count three, aggravated assault. Certainly not guilty. The only way that Ms. Douglas is convicted in this case is that if we're sending a message that it's okay for a woman not to defend herself.
This is specifically why I teach you men to be careful of these Eves. Be careful. Be very careful. This is ludicrous.
Assistant District Attorney Megan Bowden told jurors they should be insulted by some of the assertions made by the defense. She highlighted conflicting statements in Douglas's testimony about the timeline of events and her dead husband's character.
Is this our standard in Columbus? That a man who tried to do the right thing to marry this woman because she had problems and he wanted to get her help. He never put his hands on her or anyone.
So Mahara Khan, your accusations about him putting his hands on her when she was suffering domestic violence has no validity in the law. There was never any indications of abuse proven or her actually contacting the police. So according to this lawyer, the brother wanted out of the marriage, yet he ended up paying with his life. Akin, beware.
Ultimately, the jury unanimously agreed Douglas was guilty of malice murder, felony murder, and aggravated assault. Douglas faces 30 years or more in prison.